answered all the questions. You know, they were like, why would Google call this, you know, wellness check on you? And I said, well, because I'm a whistleblower, and I showed them the proof, which was a copy of the letter that I had sent the DOJ. And the police officer was like, oh my gosh, you really are a whistleblower. And I went, yep. And so then everything de-escalated. They knew that the call was false. The bomb squad cleared it. Everybody went back to normal. I got in my house, and the next day I was out of San Francisco, and I was in Washington, D.C. in a safe house. We got Sarah Carter to, like, you know, pump up the story. I went to New York. I did the disclosure, and the story went viral. It got disclosed. All the documents, you know, 950 pages were released. And that first day that it got released, there was an email notification that Project Veritas received for each time that the link was downloaded. And that link was downloaded, it was just going, like, just constantly, you know, more than 1 second for, like, hours. And they had thousands, tens of thousands of downloads of this link. So we believe that every intelligence agency and technology company around the world got a copy of this and said, oh, this is how Google's doing it. And they got to see the things that, like, their censorship was literally designed as using Comey's investigation of Trump as the way to boost stories of Google News, for example. So now all this stuff, all the dirty laundry of Google is now aired out for everyone to see. What happened after that? Like, there was, within 30 days, maybe it was 60, antitrust investigations were launched by, you know, the DOJ. 51 state attorney generals got together and started their antitrust action. And then also the city of New York. So three administration levels within the government got together and pushed this antitrust action onto Google. And I won't claim that it was because of me, but it happened within, you know, 30 to 60 days of me disclosing all this to the general public, which was my hope. Like, this was a gift I wanted to give to the American people and also the attorneys that wanted to get through the electronic discovery moat that, you know, Google had built around its castle. And so with this, I was like, okay, you guys are going to be able to crack this, A, to suddenly get in there and prove all these damages and all this censorship. And so, you know, that's what's happening right now. Like, we've got, I guess, a large antitrust act is going to be announced in the summer. And I think that, you know, the censorship that's happening with the elections is not going to get better. It's going to get worse. I think it's going to get really bad in September, October. And I'm really afraid of the president and his allies about whether they're actually going to be able to get the mission or their statement across, or whether, you know, Twitter will ban everything that Trump says and bans all the supporters that are trying to talk about it. I think that's what's going to happen. There's going to be a possibility of a total information lockdown. And every single day that, you know, progresses, the more my dystopian concern becomes more of a reality. And that's why I'm here fighting today, because I know what the deep state is able to pull off. I know that they're able to pull off this global warming scam. I know that they're able to put zoonotic mouse retroviruses in our vaccines. They're able to put mercury in our filling. They're able to put fluoride in our water and in our toothpaste. And they're able to do this in order to make us sick so that it necessitates the need of a socialized healthcare. And if we don't take socialized healthcare, then we're going to get bankrupted by the diseases that we're getting because of the medications that they're mandating that we take, like vaccinations. And
that's
so,
not gonna happen, Zach. That is not going to happen. We will not let it happen. We have millions of people with us. Not going to happen. Not going to happen.
Yeah.
And I just have to say, this is so shocking, but at the same time, so encouraging that you have come on the scene for such a time as this. We've been fighting this for so long, and you're mentioning fluoride and retroviruses, vaccines, mercury, all those things. We cover that and more, all of the health aspects of it. We've partnered with these doctors. We understand the corruption, the censorship, and we're covering it. We have millions of people that follow us. Millions of people know about you. We're partnered with other influencers that have millions. So we can overcome this. The thing is that I try to help people understand, Zach, is we are so much stronger than them. Because, like you said, if they can keep this in the dark and we don't know, they could win. And that's why they've deplatformed us. And by God's grace, we got so many people that said, hey, Jack, what are you doing? You know, so they put us back because we got a lot of pushback there. But they're literally purging their platforms of patriots, people that back Trump, and people that love America, and people that understand all these other things that support you or our work. But we're so much stronger because we have so many people that we love. We love these people. We're doing it for them, just like you're doing it for the world, America, people, mm-hmm. generations.
That was part one. I'm gonna watch part two and three. Finish this cube real quick.
Maybe.